Sam here from Creative Minds. In this week's video, we're talking about a new extension available with the CM Tooltip Glossary. It's called Community Terms. This allows your site's users, anonymous or registered, to add and suggest new terms to your site's glossary. You can also moderate these terms before they're added, and this plugin is available with all editions of the CM Tooltip Glossary, including the free edition. So let's get started. So the first thing you're going to need to do is install the extension. So the way you do this is you go to Plugins, and then you go ahead and search for the extension. It's called Community Terms. And then you can go ahead and activate that extension. Once you've activated the extension, you're going to have to go into your CM Tooltip Glossary and input the license key here on this license page. So once you've installed the extension and you've put in your license key, when someone sees your glossary index page, this Suggest a Term button will appear. The Suggest a Term button will also appear when someone visits a term page. So as you can see here on this term page, we have the Suggest a Term button. So let's take a look at what that user's gonna see once they click on the Suggest a Term button. It's gonna bring them to this form page. You can customize every single aspect of this form, but basically the user is going to be prompted to put in the title of the term they want to suggest and also a description here. And all of the usual formatting is available. You can even include links as well. Now, because I'm logged into the site, it's not prompting me to put in my email, but if an anonymous user wants to suggest a term, it's going to prompt them to put in their email just so you know who is associated with that term suggestion. And here at the bottom of the form, you can see that there's a CAPTCHA. You can actually disable this if you want to, but what this CAPTCHA does is make sure that it's just humans who are entering terms on your site. So once this user suggests a term, a message will appear alerting the user that this term has been saved and that it's waiting for moderation. You can change the settings so that you don't have to moderate the new terms and they can go directly into your glossary database. And let's take a look at the settings to see exactly how you can customize your community terms. So now we're back on the dashboard, and as you can see, there is an alert on the admin panel saying that there are 4 pending terms waiting for approval. So when someone submits that term, the admin is going to be alerted. There are terms that they need to approve in order to get them published in the glossary. So to go ahead and approve those terms, you can go to the terms list, and then you can sort by pending. And then you can go ahead and click publish, put it straight into your glossary database, or you can go ahead and edit that term before you publish it. So you have complete control over what is actually ending up on your site. And you can edit terms that people suggest. You can change the description or tags associated with that term. You can assign categories. You can make sure that this term fits into your glossary the way you want it to before you publish that term. So inside of your CM Tooltip Glossary, if you go to Settings, once you've installed the extension, you can see that the Community Terms tab appears under Settings. So this is where you can customize your Community Terms extension. Under Form Settings, this is where you enable or disable that CAPTCHA from appearing when someone wants to suggest a term. Moderation Settings, here you can adjust how you want to moderate the suggested terms. So you can either have those terms appear directly in the glossary without moderating them at all, or you can choose to moderate the terms. And you can also adjust who can add terms. You can select one or more types of users, and you can just command click, and that way you can get multiple types of users to add terms. Next, under notification settings, this is where you're going to customize how the admin and the user who has suggested a term is going to be notified on the status of that term. So you can either have your admin receive notification in their dashboard or by email, and you can also customize how that email is going to be titled and the text of that email that the admin receives, and the same for the user so that they know the status of the term that they have suggested, whether it has been published or not. Under form labels and placeholders, this is where you're going to customize the form that someone fills out when they want to suggest a term. So you can change everything from the title text to the button text. It could say, enter a new term here, or whatever you want it to say. You can also customize the text that appears for all the types of notifications associated with that suggested term, from the moderation to whether or not has been saved or published.
So let's talk about some of the benefits of the Community Terms extension. First of all, it's a great way to engage your site's users, both visitors and registered users, by allowing them to add and suggest new terms to the glossary site. Second, to build up your glossary with increasingly relevant terms for your site's users. And lastly, this extension also allows the administrator to choose which of these suggested terms actually appear in the site's glossary, so you still have full control over your site's content.